All right. Anyway, you got the essential question here. What I want to do is we're going to start with some sample problems of what we just learned for refraction. And so the way lenses work is because of refraction. Refraction is when waves bend because they speed up or slow down. So let's see if we can do a sample here before we get into lenses. Let's draw a surface. What do you want our two substances to be? Think of the demo you did earlier today. Oil would be on top and water's on the bottom. And it turns out that in oil, light goes a little bit slower. And we know that because the number on it was bigger. And in water, it goes a little bit faster. Okay? So if we had a light ray coming in, so let's use red for a red laser. And we have a light ray coming into the water. What's going to happen for how this light ray would bend? Which way is this light going to bend? What is that? Okay, we need to come, maybe we need to come up with a definition for what this would be, right? So what we do is we call it this. This is called the normal. Have you used this word in math class yet, called normal?
No.
Simply all it means is 90 degrees or perpendicular to the surface, okay? And so what we have here is if the light went straight on through, that's what it would look like if it didn't speed up or slow down. But it is going to bend. So which way is this thing going to bend? Is it going to bend so it bends? Here's your two options. Is it going to bend towards the normal, or is it going to bend away from the normal? Here's the way you can figure it out. So what I did is I drew back in the wave front. All right, remember, rays are just 90 degrees to the waves. So which side of the wave is going to hit the water first? This side will. And which side's going to hit it later? This side will. Now take a look. What did we just say about oil and water? Water has the light go a little bit faster. Oil has to go a little bit slower. So this side is going to kind of stay stopped. And this side's going to go faster, causing the wave to pivot this direction. Now, this needs to be at a 90-degree angle. And if I take a look, it looks like what it would actually do is it's going to pivot away from the normal. Okay? And so a lot of people said that, and so that's the way the light would bend. Good so far? All right, let's do another example, shall we? We are going to use those, yep. Okay. Let's do this. Let's do a challenge problem for you. I don't want to do that.
Water is water.
All right, what substances should we use here? Let's see here. Let's go from, let's do this. Let's have it be drawn like it was coming. Do you want to be like, I don't know. Let's do this. Air, glass, air, glass, air. This shouldn't be that weird to you because how often you look through glass? Those of you that are wearing glasses look through it all the time.
Yeah.
Okay? But if you looked out a window, you're looking through glass all the time. So let's do this. Let us get our angle coming in. And what I want you to do is draw this to the best of your ability. And show me, would it go towards the normal or away from the normal? Draw its path through these materials. Work with the person sitting next to you. Ready, go. Imagine the wave front. Do you see how each side of the wave is coming in at a different thing? Now, in air, is the light going to go faster or slower than in glass? It's going to be fast in air, slow in glass, and then fast again. So what's going to happen when it gets to the glass? This is the side that's going to sit still, which means this is the side that's going to pivot, and so it will bend towards the normal. Now, what would happen over here when it hits again? It's the exact opposite of what we had before, right? Now when the wave front hits, this is the side that's then slow. This is the side that's now fast. So this is the side that's going to pivot. And here's the important thing. Do you see how it's going from air to glass, and then it's going back from glass to air? The amount of pivot would be the same in both cases. It has to go back to the original angle. It's just slightly offset. How is this possible? Right, the light that's coming out of the pool is being refracted and shifted over. So you see the person, but the light on top isn't being bent, so it looks like the person is shifted over, right?
So we have a light in the back, and what we're trying to do is get that light to show up on this wall, which it is, but it doesn't show up clear until we use the lens to bend or refract the light in just the right way that when they cross, we get a sharp image right there. Now what I wanted to take a look at is we'll draw a couple lenses and see how the physics of this works.
Back on. This is what we call a ray diagram, and it's very simple. What we do here is I have what we would call a convex lens. Why do we call this one a convex as opposed to a concave?
Because it's going out.
Yeah, it's getting fatter in the middle and skinnier on the sides. Now, this is made of glass. The lenses are made of glass, and so what will happen is when the light hits it, it'll speed up and slow down, causing the light to bend, right? And I can do a real quick example of that. If we were to draw a light ray coming in here, do you see how if the light ray hit, here's its wavefront? Do you see how this side would hit first, causing it to slow down and then bend, kind of something like that? Okay? So those are lenses. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at three rays that come in to help us do what's going on. Before we can do that, though, we're going to need an object. What's the thing to notice about a candle is on the tip of the flame, which direction is it sending light out? And the answer is?
Everywhere.
Thank you. It's every direction. So you got a little bit of light coming out in every direction on that candle. And it turns out, though, we don't need an infinite number of rays to describe what's going on with this candle. We only need three. And the first one that's easiest to explain what's going on is take a line. Let's see if I can get this line tool to come back up. And have a line that comes in parallel to the axis that we have there. Do you see this? Any light that comes in parallel or perpendicular to the lens or parallel to the major axis, when it comes through, it will refract through what we call the focal point. Now, if you've ever used a magnifying glass to try and burn something outside, you're familiar with the idea of the focal point. Okay? So any light that comes in parallel, it's going to refract so that when it refracts through the focal point. Yeah. Got what I'm saying?
So
all the parallel rays come in. Okay, so that's the important thing. It turns out if you have another ray, here's the one we have. It's one that goes right through the center of the lens. And if it goes right through the center of the lens, what's cool about this is, if you take a look here, this ray would hit in such a way that this part refracts first, but then when it gets to the other side, this is the part that then speeds back up. And so the refraction is canceled out. And so what it does is it travels right on through with no bending whatsoever. Okay? Here's the last one. If you got a focal point on one side of your lens, you also have a focal point on the other. And so to the best of my ability, and if you have a ruler here, you should do the same. Try and draw wherever you put your focal point, put it the same distance on the other side. Okay? So when you're drawing your focal point, have this distance be the same as that distance. Are you following me here? Okay. The last ray that we want to take a look at is any ray that travels through the front focal point. When it hits the lens, what it's going to do is just like the ones before that came out parallel, this one is going to come out, or the ones that came in parallel that went through the focus, if they go through... if they go through the front focal point, they come out parallel to the axis. Now, you'll notice that when I was doing this, my drawing didn't come out exactly perfect, right? I tried the best I could, and so what'll happen is, a lot of the times, your lines should all meet at the same point. Sometimes they don't. That's not because of the physics it's wrong, it's because maybe you didn't have it completely parallel. Maybe you didn't have the distances exactly right in your drawing. Are you with me on this?
Yeah.
Now, what that means is, if we put this all together, this light started here. It's now showing up over here to focus back together. So what have we just made? We have made an image of the candle on the other side. Now, what do you notice? Those of you that were in the back room with me, when we did the skull and crossbones light, or even the candle up here, when we made the image, did it show up right side up, or was it flipped over upside down? Do you see how this is matching with what we would predict it to be?
All right, so in conclusion, there's three rays I want you to take a look at. The first one is one that comes in parallel. It will refract through the far focal point. The next ray is a ray that comes through the center of the lens. Now, I misspoke saying it doesn't refract at all. It will. It just acts in such a way that it's canceled out. And the last ray is one that goes through the front focus, and it will come out parallel on the far side. If you have any questions, come see me in class.